Every grain of the rice is coated in that puli ogre masala. It's a simple one dish sort of a meal, but it's a riot of textures. Rice Nallagiri. And this, I'm told, is a recipe of the Nalla Maharaja.
So we are actually visiting Sangeeta and Kanan at their home.
House, yes.
Yeah, and we're eating a meal at your home.
Exactly.
The Chakra Pongal. You know, I love the earthy sweetness that jaggery brings to a dish.
Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're staying safe and strong. We're just outside the walls of Lal Bagh in South Bengaluru. Speaking of which, I hope you caught our vlog on our Lal Bagh walk, followed by our delicious Idli Vade breakfast in the second channel, Kripal Amana. If you haven't caught that vlog yet, I'm going to post a link here and also in the description below. So today we are on our way to NR Colony here in Basavanagudi, and this is part of our quest to help small businesses, small eateries showcase the interesting things that they do in these very difficult times. So the eatery that we're about to visit today does some Iyengar food, and I'm told they do Iyengar food in its truest form. It's been around only for about 2 or 3 years, but in this short span of time has managed to endure itself to locals in the area. So let's go to this eatery, which is interestingly called Eat Repeat, and taste some Iyengar, pure Iyengar Oota. Here we are at Eat Repeat, ensconced in an interesting space in a tiny by lane of NR Colony. Spaces like these always have something interesting to offer, because I believe in the tiniest of spaces, one usually is rewarded with the biggest of surprises. Namaskara.
Namaskara.
How are you doing?
Good, great. Welcome to Eat Repeat.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here.
Yeah.
The space looks rather interesting with the mural out in front. And also some
all
of these.
So we did a little colloquial, you know, slangs.
Busy, busy, masale kodappa. Strong filter copy.
Yeah. Token number 20.
Token number 20, not 20, 20.
Namaskara, Basu.
Adho, boss ubarate ala.
Correct.
Tiffinu.
And even
Waku.
This.
That is a very typical way of how we love to speak a Kannada here. Adho, u on the emphasis barate, it makes it interesting. So I'm with Sangeeta and Kanan, the couple behind Eat Repeat.
Correct. Correct.
So how did Eat Repeat come about? So
we both are IT professionals.
Okay.
She quit her job in 2013.
Okay.
I quit in 2017.
Okay.
She pursued Bharatanatyam as her career.
Huh.
And I got into food and hospitality, catering services. So we wanted a space where we can give experience to our clients. So we want an experience center for food. That's
okay.
How Eat Repeat came into existence in 2018, yeah.
So the food that you serve is very traditional Iyengar cuisine, right?
Correct.
So it's a sort of food that involves no onion, no garlic.
No onion, no garlic. No then preservatives,
no
artificial colors.
Nothing.
So no exorbitant sodas and other stuff, nothing of that sort. It's authentic and traditional food.
Fresh, just a home-cooked food.
Just home-cooked food.
Yeah.
And how did the name Eat Repeat come about? One would imagine you to get a name which speaks a lot about your Iyengar heritage and all of that.
So the name, why we chose Eat Repeat was, it's a food which you can eat daily. You will not get boredom about it. You can eat puli ogre every day. You can eat rice rasam every day, rice sambar every day. So the food that we serve is something that you can eat every day. So you eat once and then you repeat again.
We used to be open 6 days a week. The kind of mixed variety rice that we do, or the sambar or rasam that we do, we always change the vegetables that we use. So not one is repeated in the entire week. So every day you get to have a different kind of sambar, or a different kind of mor kolambo or rasam.
Seasonal ingredients.
Yeah.
Andre manetara. So
manetara.
At home, how your
your mother or your wife would change the curries,
menus,
the menu every day. Exactly. Similarly, at Eat Repeat, you don't. So basically, things change on a daily basis.
Right.
Puliyogare and Sathra Pongal Ambode, they remain constant all throughout.
They're the pillars of a traditional Iyengar meal. Correct.
ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರೆ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್ ರಸಂನೆಲ್ಲ ವಿ ಕೀಪ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ದ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮದ್ರಾಸ್ ರಸಂ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟೊ ಜೀರಾ ರಸಂ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಕೊಳಂಬ್ನಲ್ಲೂ ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಪಂಪ್ಕಿನ್ ಆರ್ ಆಶ್ ಗಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಜ್ಜಿಗೆ ಹುಳಿ ಮೋರ್ ಕೊಳಂಬ್ ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡೂ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೂ ಬೆಂಡೆಕಾಯಿ ಸೀಮೆ ಬದನೆಕಾಯಿ ಸೊಪ್ಪು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ಅಪ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್
ಕುಕುಂಬರ್ ಪಾಲಕ್ ದ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕುಕುಂಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಾಲಕ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅನ್ ಇಂಗ್ರೀಡಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಜ್ಜಿಗೆ ಹುಳಿ
And
which is very different.
That balka ante heltivi upachi menshinkai ante heltare we give that you know as a add on adu ni one bite idu one bite
correct
that's how you eat at home right
correct
majge udi so we give that
very nice the space that you have is quite quaint you stay here
yeah
we stay upstairs this is a house
okay so we are actually visiting Sangeeta and Kanan at their home
yeah
and we are eating a meal at your home
absolutely and what we do here is the primary food the puliyogare sakrai pongal rice sambar and all great script prepared in my centralized kitchen which is my catering kitchen
so you also have a catering business
I also have a catering business
okay
so I have a centralized kitchen where I have my regular chefs my traditional cooks and everybody
okay.
who prepare these foods they have learned from their forefathers and great fathers so the recipes have you know a generation of recipes which have come in so we cook in that particular traditional method like using the brass vessel
okay
we cook it and that it comes here
so, I can see that copper on there for water
that's the water
that's my great grandfather's
oh really
yeah that's a hande which we used to use for heating water
ole wood fire mele saude ele mele
we converted that to a water pot
So speaking of the food, what is the menu? I can see the menu here. Masala dosa, bende khali dosa, puri tatte idli, puri dosa, akki roti, tatte idli. So idella change aagutte kelava
ella. Yeah, all the breakfast items remain the same.
Okay.
But ee annada items matra like today we have special nalagiri anta.
Nalagiri andre sambar type ala.
Ha, idu boodumulaka alsande kaal haaki.
Ash gourd.
Ash gourd and alsande kaal pulses.
Okay.
So
Spring
that's
beans. Can we take a look at the kitchen?
Absolutely.
See what's happening.
Please come. Please come.
We have changed the setup a little because of corona because this used to be our dining area.
Okay.
So we have rearranged it based on the corona COVID line. We don't leave anybody inside now.
Okay. Iga illi enide?
So we have the red chutney.
This is basically kadle bele chutney.
Kadle bele chutney, huh?
This is actually done in all Brahmin household. This is a beautiful combination with tatte idli.
With tatte idli and the color comes from mention kai.
Yes.
Biryani
and guntur.
And
this is the chutney little watery for the khali dosa.
For the khali dosa.
Khali dosa and puri dosa and paper dosa. And this is a little thicker for the masala dosa. Idralli coconut green chilli so. This is ambode.
Ambode.
That's a sakra pongal.
Sakra pongal.
Sakra pongal. And this is made of rice, moong dal, dry coconut, jaggery. Garnishing with cashews and raisins and ghee.
This is the puliyogare. So this is basically done with the paste. We make our own puliyogare paste.
The puliyogare gojju, as we call it.
The main ingredients of gojju is tamarind, jaggery, and rasam powder and oil. Those are the main ingredients. We don't put groundnut and other things tadka to the gojju directly. Tadka is added while we are mixing.
Typically, what they do is they make the tadka on the pan, then the gojju goes in.
Yes.
And then the rice goes in.
Right.
Is that how you do it?
Rice is separately kept.
ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ
Okay.
That goes on top of it while mixed. She is our main cook, Shashi.
Namaskara.
She does all the breakfast items.
So, dosa.
We work together. This is tatte idli.
And what is in the idli batter?
Idli batter has only avalakki,
okay.
urad dal and rice.
Idli rice.
Idli rice. Yes. So, is there a proportion in which you grind it?
Yes. 1 kg of idli, rice. Then we add 500 grams of urad dal. 250 grams of avalakki. Gatti avalaki, not the paper avalaki.
Oh, gatti avalaki.
Soak it overnight. 9 hours of soaking.
Soaking.
Then the grinding. And then 8 hours or 9 hours of fermentation.
Fermentation. So this idli, the process has started yesterday.
Yes.
ಇದು ಖಾಲಿ ದೋಸೆ
ದೋಸೆ ಬಂದೆ ಹಾ
and this is masala dosa pudi dosa paper dosa batter
so this is your potato
yeah potato mixture
without onion
without onion so what do you do to give it that flavor punch
basically we add ginger because I feel ginger is a beautiful substitute for anything I mean you don't require onion actually to be very frank
when you eat this palya you can taste every ingredient you can taste the ginger you can taste the turmeric onion is a fantastic vegetable no doubt its flavor is very strong it overpowers every other flavors best part is you can taste every single flavor in that palya that's the difference
this is the pudi that we make this is basically chutney pudi this is my mom's recipe
chutney pudi idralli enenide ellide idralli ellide karbeve
ide idralli uddin bele ide
kadle bele ide
equal quantities and then it has guntur and badgi mentioned kai tamarind
so do you dry the tamarind out before you crush it together
yes yes we do that uppu bella
bella
bella ide
kobri
kobri
kobri ide
masala dosa and pudi dosa both idike ide hogute and even for tatte illi what we make benne pudi tatte illi the same
ide hogute
yes this is our secret recipe
secret recipe I think every home I think more than a secret I think it's a way of life
yeah.
right it's recipes that have been handed down through generations and I think the custodian or the generation that's holding that recipe is very possessive about that
they are possessive about the recipe but we share the happiness because this is also for sale no
you share the food that's right so if you are here at Eat Repeat not only can you savor some of the dishes but you can also carry a tiny parcel of Eat Repeat home in the pudi and also that puliyogare yes.
puliyogare
gojju
rasam pudi sambar pudi bisibale bhat pudi whatever pudis we use we sell the same ingredients out
and of course all without the onion
and
the
garlic.
And we don't use preservatives and or any food colors so all everything is made fresh
I think I'm going to step out and meet that chutney pudi.
Yes.
Benne idli.
Benne tatte idli.
Ah, so I think that's our cue to step outside and savor the uta or the tindi here at Eat Repeat. So I think we'll do both the breakfast and lunch items. So we'll do the masala dosa, the benne kali dosa, just to give that masala dosa company. Of course, the pudi tatte idli, I definitely want to taste.
Super.
And then we will taste the puliyogare, the chakre pongal, and the rice nalagiri. And I think for a bit of a crunch, I think we will also taste the ambode.
Yes.
Benne pudi tatte idli.
Ah, thank you.
With
kadle bele chutney.
Yes.
Well, the food's here, so the mask goes off. That certainly seems to be an idli that's rather soft and fluffy. There's wisps of steam that's escaping as I break that idli. Even as the idli came to my table, I could smell the aroma of that pudi. Oh, that's a tasty pudi. So it's kara sa ide. You got that spice, the spice of the chili. There's also a bit of tartness that I taste from that tamarind, from the hunse annu. And then also the nutty flavor of the yeldu or the sesame seeds. This is an idli that I definitely want to get better acquainted with. That butter also serves to calm down the fiery aggression of that pudi. The idli is soft, fluffy, and because it's an idli that's made with the rice, the idlis also come together in a light, fluffy sort of a texture. This is not an idli where you will taste the gari gari of the rice rava. And I think that's this idli's ode to the Tamil traditions that it comes from. So in Karnataka here, we like to use a rice thari. But when it comes to Tamil style of idli, it's usually the rice that is soaked and then ground along with the urad dal and also some of the other ingredients that each eatery may have. There's also a hint of sweetness that I can taste from the bella, from the jaggery. Oh, that's a delicious idli. I love the way the idli comes together. I think that pudi is quite interesting. There's also a bit of the crunch that I'm tasting of the lentils in that pudi. That pudi is a riot of flavors. So you've got that toastiness of the yeldu or the sesame seeds. You got that hint of sweetness that comes from the jaggery. There's a bit of the tartness from the hunse annu. And then of course, the gari gari or that toasted crunch from the lentils. And needless to say, the chilies do well to leave behind its spicy impression on your throat. I think let's now taste that kadle bele chutney. I can taste some curry leaf in there for sure. Sakat kar aaya hai. That's a chutney that's quite spicy. Let's savor some of that tatte idli with that chutney. When you taste the chutney by itself, it's a sort that's quite spicy and I'm sure definitely has me sweating at the back of my head. But when you taste it with the idli, that idli almost asks that chutney to behave. So you're not really tasting too much of that spicy punch. I also like that slight hint of tartness that you're tasting in that idli. You know, it's been a while since I've had an idli that's prepared with the rice that is ground into that batter. And the texture of that idli is completely different. It's soft and fluffy, but the sort that comes together on your bite. When you place an idli that's made mostly with the rice thari, that idli disintegrates into tiny particles. This is a sort of idli that comes together when you break a piece of it and also stays together when you place it in your mouth. Of course, along with that flavorful hit of that puri. That puri is very special. I love the freshness that you're tasting in that chutney. So there is a spicy hit of that chili. There's also some tempering that you taste in the sasve. But what I also like is the refreshing flavors of the curry leaf and the coriander that you taste in the chutney as well. To me personally, this isn't a chutney that I will slather over my idli, but this is a chutney that I will approach only in the secure company of that idli, and that too for just a tiny dab of its spicy, aggressive flavors. But it's the puri that's made to Sangeeta and Kannan's family recipe, that is surely the hero on this plate of the puri benne tatte idli. I think I'm going to savor the last bite of this idli all by itself, because I want to wash some of the flavors of that spicy chutney as I prepare my palate to meet the dosa here at Eat Repeat. When you're sitting here for a meal, it doesn't seem like you're sitting in a commercial eatery. It feels like you're sitting in someone's home, and that's really where we are sitting. We're sitting in Sangeeta and Kannan's home. They live upstairs and they serve dishes made to recipes of their family down below. And what we have here next is a dosa. It's only natural that the dosa follows the idli. And we have two dosas here, the khali dosa and also a masala dosa. I love the roast of that masala dosa. And the other interesting aspect to this dosa is the fact that there's no onion in that masala. So that certainly is a dosa that I'm looking forward to tasting. But I think we should make a beginning with that khali dosa, with the soft and spongy khali dosa. And of course, like they say, benne makes everything better, butter makes everything better. There's some butter both on the khali dosa as well as the masala dosa. And the dosa is served with a chutney. And in true Bengaluru tradition, it's a combination of the urugadle and also some kai. You can see that benne that has seeped into the thousands of pores in that khali dosa. What's also interesting in this khali dosa is because it's roasted on both sides, more on the bottom and a little lesser on the second side, there's a bit of a caramelized crust too that's formed on that dosa. And part of that crust also comes from a bit of sugar that goes into the batter just before that dosa is ladled onto that tawa, that cast iron tawa, and roasted. There's definitely a little more than a hint of tartness that I'm tasting in that dosa. And the slightest whisper of a crunch from that roasted crust that's scattered atop this dosa. The dosa is soft and spongy, like a khali dosa should be. But there definitely is that tartness, that hint of tartness, or slightly more than a hint of tartness that I'm tasting in that dosa. And I think that's where that chutney will come into play. I think that chutney balances out against the slight sour edge of that dosa. That's a thick chutney. The mustard seeds, the curry leaf, those are the sort of flavors that you're tasting on the palate, along with a creamy bite of that urugadle that is ground together with some kai, with some coconut. You know, unlike the benne pudi, tatte idli, where you were focusing more on the idli with that delicious pudi that was topped on it, here, I think that chutney plays as important a role as that dosa, because the spicy, slightly creamy texture of that urugadle chutney that balances out against the tartness of this dosa. And the chutney too is of the texture that you can generously scoop into the fold of your khali dosa. You definitely want to be tasting more of that chutney with that khali dosa here. I think illi, if you do two khali dosa itara, you will need a repeat of the chutney. There's some places you go where that chutney is thin, it's almost watery. But out here, the chutney is slightly gutty. It's neither watery nor it is too gutty. So it's a sort of chutney that really encourages you to embrace it over and over again with each scoop of that dosa. I've got my second khali dosa here too to savor. But I want to get to that masala dosa in a hurry. So therefore, this scoop will only be that of the dosa. I want to cleanse my palate of some of the flavors of the chutney before I say hello to that masala dosa, that Iyengar style masala dosa at Eat Repeat that is minus any iruli or the onions. That dosa is rather thick, and that chutney pudi, I'm told, is the X factor ingredient that livens up that dosa. The palya here is also embellished with some peas. I'm sure there's some coriander in there too, or perhaps some curry leaves. I'm not sure. But let's savor that benne masala dosa to find out what lurks within. You know, the challenging thing for me as a food reviewer is sometimes you want to call for both the dishes together, and that's what I just did. So this dosa has had to wait while I tasted one of those khali dosas. So obviously, I think some of that crispy crunch that you would find in this dosa, the moment it came off that tawa, seems to have waned a wee bit. What's interesting here is the texture of that palya. That palya is mostly pasty in its texture, but then I can also taste tiny flecks of some ginger, and I'm certainly sure that I bit into a green chili that set the tip of my tongue on fire. There's a faint whisper of a crunch that the dosa still manages to hold on to, but this is a dosa that's slightly thick. As it comes off that tawa, I'm sure there'll be a bit more of a crunch, but this is the sort of dosa that you'll probably find at home. And as you taste the borders of that dosa, you're certainly rewarded with more of that crunch. That's where that dosa still has its crunch intact. So this is a Iyengar style masala dosa without any onion in the palya. So am I missing the onion in the palya? Well, I think a dosa that has onion in its masala will taste slightly different, because you'll have that savory flavors of the onion that's quite dominant, and that in a manner of speaking takes over the palate, complementing the aloo gedde and some of the other ingredients in that. But out here, you're tasting perhaps more of the ingredients that have gone into that masala. So I can definitely taste a bit of that green chili. I can taste some of that ginger. I can taste that saswe that's probably gone in as a tempering and then is mixed together, crushed together with the potatoes to make that palya. That's really what you're tasting. But the one supreme flavor that stands tall here is that chutney pudi. So I think if you are here at Eat Repeat, savor all these dishes for sure, but also carry home some of that chutney pudi. That chutney pudi is definitely a delicious find that will allow you to savor the flavors that you've tasted here also in the comfort of your home. The flavors that you've tasted in Sangeeta and Kannan's home also in your home. Let's go for a scoop of that chutney next. I'm also tasting some of the fresh flavors of the herbs in that chutney. So this is a dosa that's crunchy on the outside and gets progressively softer as you work your way to the center, especially along with that palya, that no niruli alugadde palya. That water is cool as it sits in that urn, and there's definitely the flavor of the pacha karpura, the edible camphor, and a few other aromatic ingredients that have gone into that water. It's quite similar in flavor to the teertha that you get in temples. That's exactly the sort of flavor that this water conveys to your palate. And now to wait for the puli ogre, the chakre pongal, and also the abbode. Well, if you're at an Ayangari eatery, that puli ogre is a must. And to keep company with that puli ogre, we also have what is called the rice nalagiri, a sambar of sorts with the ash gourd and also some alsande kalu. And then of course the ambode. This is not the masal vade because there's no onion in it. This is the ambode minus any onion or garlic. Let's begin though with that puli ogre. I think the best way to go for the puli ogre is with your fingers. I've said it a million times and I will say it again. When you touch food, it connects you to the dish even before you taste it. It heightens your sense of anticipation. In a manner of speaking, they also say it charges the food when you touch the food with your fingers as you savor it. This seems to be a puli ogre that's liberally coated with that puli ogre paste, with that puli ogre goju as they call it. And the main component of a puli ogre, of course, is the tamarind. Enough talking, let's get to the puli ogre. Every grain of the rice is coated in that puli ogre masala. I'm also tasting a bit of the kai, a bit of the coconut also in the bite. They make the puli ogre goju first, which is of course the tamarind paste, and then that's combined with a whole bunch of spices. There's some lentils that go into it, some coriander, some cumin, some pepper, red chili, etc. And then that comes together with a tamarind paste in a tempering of sort, and that's mixed into the rice. And out here I'm told they hand mix the rice with that puli ogre goju, because that way they ensure every grain of the rice is coated with that puli ogre goju. This puli ogre definitely has plenty happening in it. Apart from the fried curry leaves, you also have the peanuts. There's some chilies in there. There's also the warmth of the red chilies that you're tasting in there. And that of course is the coconut, the kobri, or the dried coconut that is roasted. This is a simple one dish sort of a meal, but it's a riot of textures. You got a soft bite of the rice grain. You got a bit of that heat. This puli ogre is not spicy, but it's certainly warming, because you can feel the warmth of the red chili at the back of your throat. And that's really what you're tasting. And then you have the crunch, that crunch of that coconut. Every once in a while, you bite into the nuttiness of that roasted peanut. There's also some jaggery that's gone into it, but like the chili, it plays a role in probably toning down some of the tartness, some of the sourness of the tamarind. This is a puli ogre that rewards you with the flavors of the goju with every bite. There's not a single fleck of rice that's left unstained by that goju. There's also some chili here that's fried in that tempering along with the curry leaf and the peanuts. That chili on first bite is not spicy and certainly comes across as more pulpy in its texture. But as that chili sits on your tongue, that's when it slowly begins to release its spicy hit. And that's certainly something that I'm tasting now, coating my tongue. And I think that's where that masuru comes in to calm some of that chili heat. These chilies are tiny, but they're definitely the sort that pack a punch. I can feel the searing heat of that chili on my tongue, which is why I want plenty of the masuru in the next bite of my puli ogre. When I looked at this chili first, I was wondering how much harm could it do. And so, bravely or rather foolishly, I nibbled on an entire chili. And I can certainly feel the punishment of that chili. I think if you love your puli ogre, definitely a dish to savor here at Eat Repeat. I definitely want to taste some of that yogurt before I find my way to that rice nallagiri. Thank you. Puli ogre done, time to move to the rice nallagiri. And this, I'm told, is a recipe of the Nalla Maharaja, the Maharaja who loved this food and he loved to cook. And the speciality here is that you have the Bhut Kumlakai or the ash gourd and the Alsande Kalu. Ah, this sambar, as we would see it and call it, is piping hot. Bisi de guru, bisi de. That Bhut Kumlakai, as you place in your mouth, dissolves away, and because it has soaked up the flavors of that nallagiri, as it dissolves, it leaves behind a pool of that sambar on your tongue. This is a sambar that is quite calming in its flavors. You definitely have the creamy texture of the lentil. So I think the lentils have been boiled first and then crushed into a paste as they find the way into that pot in which the vegetables are cooked. Of course, along with some of that masala that goes in, but that lentil is decipherable only in the creamy texture that it imparts this sambar. But the flavors are quite gentle. There's a bit of the puli that you taste from the tamarind for sure, and perhaps I think also some jaggery. Traditional food is all about balance. So you'll have some warmth that comes from the red chili. You'll have the jaggery that will lend a tinge of sweetness, not to sweeten the dish, but to balance out against perhaps the spicy notes of the chili or the puli of the tamarind. And I think that's what traditional food is all about. Traditional food is all about balance. It's about finding harmony in the various flavors and thereby the various ingredients that go in. And if you find that harmony, that's where even a simple dish like this rice nallagiri or the rice and sambar can acquire a sublime disposition. And it's always nice to have a bit of a fried sort of a dish on your plate. And this is the ambode, not the masal vade, the ambode, because there's no onion that's gone into this. So this is basically the kadle pele that you can see crushed and also whole inside. There's some green chili in there, there's some red chili flecks that you can see as well. There's also the flavor of the curry leaf. Typically in the masal vade they put some sapsike soppu, but out here I'm not sure. Of course, the ambode is not piping hot because this is prepared at the central kitchen and then brought to the store. So I think the ambode here is more like an add-on. If you're having the rice and sambar, the rice and nallagiri, I think it provides for that element of crunch. Some more busy, busy sambar. Thank you. So when you're eating here at Eat Repeat and you feel like an extra ladle of that sambar, the couple here is kind enough to oblige. When you're eating Anna Sambar, of course the first bite is busy busy. But as you get towards the end, we're in an open atmosphere, so that sambar loses its temperature. So there's nothing like refreshing your plate with a steaming hot ladle of that nallagiri. I love the pulpy texture of that ash gourd. And if you want a bit of a crunchy sort of a bite, go for some of that ambode in that rice and sambar scoop. You know, the flavors of the food here are quite calming. I've eaten all these dishes. I've had the puri idli, I've had the khali dosa, I've had the masal dosa, I've had the puli ogre, and now I'm working my way through this rice nallagiri. But it isn't causing any sort of uneasiness. It fills you, certainly, but in a very happy sort of way. And I think the other interesting thing out here, as Kannan pointed out, is they've kept the prices low and they've also kept the portion sizes accordingly. So when you come here, depending on your appetite, you can order as many dishes as you like. And even if you have a small appetite, you can be sure that there will be no food left wasted on your plate. That Alsande Kalu works to complement or to complete the nutrition aspect of this rice Nallagiri Uta. I love how that Boodh Kumlakai has soaked up some of the tart flavors of that sambar. To end a leisurely amble through some of the Iyengar delicacies here at Eat Repeat, the Chakkara Pongal, as they would call it in Tamil. But out here, it is the Sakkare Pongal. So the interesting thing is that the Sakkare Pongal, although we perceive that term Sakkare to mean sugar, this is a dish that's prepared with no sugar but prepared with some jaggery. So you have soaked rice and the moong dal that is pressure cooked with some milk, with some water to attain this creamy sort of a mush, and then that's combined with melted jaggery and some other ingredients to make for that Chakkara Pongal.
Chakkara Pongal is what we call it in Karnataka.
In Karnataka.
If you go to Tamil Nadu, it's called Chakkare Pongal.
Chakkare Pongal. I like that term better. Chakkare Pongal, because that also pays homage to the origin of this dish. I can also see plenty of nuts here, some godambi. There's some raisins as well. That's probably fried in ghee, allowing for that godambi to get toasted nicely with that ghee. And that's sprinkled on top of this Chakkare Pongal as it comes to a finish on the pan. Enough talking, let's get to the eating. You know, I love the earthy sweetness that jaggery brings to a dish. Sugar can get cloying. When it comes to jaggery, it leaves behind that earthy sweetness. And then, of course, the crunch of the kai and loads of tuppa, loads of ghee that you can taste. Each spoonful is lush with the ghee. That mix is quite sticky in the manner it clings to the spoon. And I think when they melt the jaggery, they also cook it to a certain extent so that jaggery becomes thick and syrupy, almost congeals itself to that rice and moong dal mix that's cooked and then mashed before being added to that jaggery. And that raisin registers itself on your palate with a pop, with a delicious pop bursting with its ripe, sweet acidity. So if you want to end your meal here on a sweet note, I think that Chakkara Pongal is certainly the way to go. And I think that godambi and that raisin, I think, is cooked in a ton of ghee. So much so that the godambi has almost become soggy, burdened with the weight of the tuppa. Well, that was an enjoyable morning here at Eat Repeat in NR Colony. I've enjoyed most of the dishes that I've tasted. That Pudi Bende, or that Bende Pudi Tatte Idli, is definitely a dish that I will return for, as also that Puli Ogare and that Rice Nallagiri. And when you're here, don't leave without tasting that Chakkare Pongal. It's heartening to discover enterprises like these, enterprises that seek to showcase their delicious culinary traditions, which is exactly what Kannan and Sangeeta have sought to do in their home. So if you're looking to savor some truly authentic Iyengar delicacies, find your way to Eat Repeat in NR Colony and support this delicious culinary enterprise. I hope you will find it in your heart to support initiatives like these that need your support, that need your encouragement, especially in the challenging times that we live in. If you can't make it to the eatery, I'm sure most of them are only a phone call or only an app order away. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, stay very strong, and happy eating.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, Do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!